In this video, we will analyze a tool which is Access Data Forensic Toolkit Imager, also known as FTK Imager. This forensic tool is used as data preview and as imaging tool. With this tool, we can also create perfect copy, also known as forensic image, of computer data without making changes to the original evidence.
These are some features provided by this tool. We can create forensic images of local hard drive, floppy disk, zip disk, CD, DVD. We can also create image of entire folder, or we can select some individual file from various place within the media. We can also preview files and folder on the local hard drive, network drive, floppy disk, zip disk, CD, and DVD. We can preview the contents of the forensic images stored on the local machine or on the network drive. We can mount an image for a read-only view that leverage Windows Explorer to see the content of the image exactly as the user saw it on the original drive. We can also export files and folder from forensic images. We can see and recover files that have been deleted from the recycle bin but have not yet been overwritten on the drive. We can also create hash of the file using one of the two available hash functions in the FTK Imager. Which one is MD5 and another is SHA1. These are functionality provided by FTK Imager. Evidence preview, image mounting, protected registry file. We can view a registry file in the Windows machine. EFS file encryption detection. If any storage device is encrypted with this EFS mechanism, we can detect that encryption. We can create forensic images. We can also create custom content image. We can capture memory, which is capturing state of current RAM. For the previewing of evidence, there are three modes available in the FTK Imager for preview of electronic data. First one is automatic mode, second is text mode, and third is hex mode. In automatic mode, for the file, whichever mode is suitable, it is displayed according to that file, either text mode or hex mode. In text mode, the content of file, if possible, is shown in ASCII value or in Unicode value. And in hex mode, the content of file is shown in a stream of hexadecimal value. Image mounting allows forensic images to be mounted as a drive or physical device. For read-only viewing, these are list of supported types by FTK Imager. First one is RAW or 3D images, E01, S01, AFF, which stands for Advanced Forensic Format, AD1, L01. Now let's move to the FTK Imager tool for analysis of digital evidence and image mounting. This is user interface of the tool. First part is evidence stream. In the evidence tree, we can see list of all available directories in the mounted image. Second part is file list. In file list, we can see list of all the files selected the directory in the evidence tree. Here we can see name of the file, size of the file type, and date of the last modified time. Third part is custom content sources. We can select a file from the available list of file in this section to send to create image of that particular file only. And the last part is for viewing of the file. We can see in two mode, either in text mode or in hex mode. Now let's starting by adding evidence item from the file menu. We can add evidence item from here. These are available source for evidence type. First one is physical drive. You can add physical drive as evidence from the available disk in this computer. We can add logical drive. We can add image file, or we can also add content of the folder. In the physical file drive option, we can see list of available hard drive connected in this computer. In the logical drive, we can see all the logical drive, this partition are made in this hard drive. Now let's start by adding simple image file. We can add file, these are available file. We have add a DD file for analysis. In the evidence tree, we can see directory structure of the file. These are two folder in this images, and in file list we can see available file in this folder. This cross icon in the name of the file indicates that these file are deleted, but that space are not overwritten by any other file, so these are marked deleted but not completely removed from the image. So we can see that file here in the unallocated space, this file also are deleted. We can see content of that file by clicking over them. If we try to analyze that file by clicking that, we can see content of that file in this section, the lower section. Here are this mode is automatic mode. Second is text mode. We can see text of that file in this section. And in hex mode, we can see hexadecimal string of that file. If we select the hexadecimal part in this file, we can analyze content in decimal value by this in the lower section, hex value interpreter. These are type and these are corresponding value. For signed integer, this is range in 1 to 8 byte. For unsigned integer, 1 to 8 byte. This is file time in UTC format, which is 8 byte. We have selected here 4 byte. If we select 8 byte here, then we can see corresponding value in file time in this section. If we select 8 byte, if we select 8 byte, then we can see corresponding time here. See, we have selected 4 byte. So here, if we select 8 byte, then we can see corresponding time in UTC and corresponding time in local. Local, which means we can see corresponding time with the time zone of this machine. Time zone with corresponding set to this machine. If we select 2 bytes, then we can see at this dose time and dose date. If we select 4 bytes, then we can see corresponding time UTC and corresponding time in local. So these are X value interpreted. By this we can selecting value corresponding from that, and we can see according value in X value interpreter. Here are two options byte order. First is little endian and other is big endian format. In the bottom line, you can see some useful property corresponding to that file in the disk geometry. If we select any segment of that file, we can see corresponding value in the bottom line. This is selection start 32, means we have selected from 32th location. A length of the selection is 4, means 4 byte. This is cluster number in the image, and which is a 206, and this is logical sector. If we move down, then we can see here dash line, which is end of the cluster, and this is the start of another cluster. As we can see here, which is cluster number 207. Here we can go down, then we can find another cluster. So these are some useful information about this file. In the property tab, we can see file of current property of the selected file from the file list. As you can see here, we can see name, file class, file size, physical size, start cluster, date created, date modified, and some another useful attribute, which is hidden, system file, read only file or not. So these are property of that file. here are list of 6 file. If we want to create image from the particular any 2 or 3 file, then we can by selecting on the file and right click and then add to custom content image. List of that selected file we can say here custom content source under this tab. If we want to create this first 2 file in another image, then we can add this file to custom content image. And then we can create image of that file.
Upon selecting this create image option, we are asked to provide destination for that image. We can add here multiple destination for the image. And first of all, we need to add evidence item information such as case number, evidence number, unique description, name of the examiner, and notes. Let's fill this information. Case number 101, evidence number 201, unique description, test case, name of the examiner. Here we have to add destination for the image. We need to provide name of the image file without extension. Here another option is fragment for image. By default option is 1500 MB, around 1.5 GB. If we want to fragment image in parts, we can provide here option. Another option is compression. There are 10 options for compression. By default, it is 6. 0 for no compression, and for 9, it is the smallest possible size. Another option is use AD encryption. If we want to encrypt our image file, then we can use this option. Let's click this option. Another option is filter by file owner. We can also add a filtering for this image. Since we have selected AD encryption, there are two possible ways. First one is entering password and another is certificate. We can provide a certificate. There are two certificate extension available, PFX, P12 and .pem. So now let's enter password for that file. We can also use another destination, and another option is add overflow location. If provided location by ourselves is not sufficient to store that image, then remaining part of that image will add that another location, which is overflow location. We are currently not adding this since our image size is too small. Here are some options, which is verify image after they created. This option use hash function to verify whether images are created or modified or not. Pre-calculate progress statistics. Upon creating this image, we will show progress of that image file. Create directory listing of all image in the image after they are created. This option add a directory listing of all files. Since this is too small file, we are it is not shown the process of that file. And upon completed that process, we can see here two hash digest for the image. One is MD5 hash and another is SHA1 hash. And both result are matched, means selected image and after creation of image, both content are same. There is no any mismatch in the file.
Now let's open that recently created image file. This .ad1 extension is a image file created by us. By default, FTK Imager provides .ad1 extension, and these are text file which contains details about that image. Here we can see cache information provided at the time of creation this image, which is cache number, evidence number, unit description, examiner, and nodes. And these are information that contain all files inside the image and complete path of the image. We have added two files in the image, and another is a hash value of the created image, MD5 checksum and SHH checksum. This another information is the acquisition started time and acquisition finish time. This is a list of all segments. Since our file only contain one segment, we can here only see one entry. This is a contain verification time. Last we have verified the image, and these are value of MD5 checksum and SHH1 checksum. Since we can see here both value are same, our image is marked as verified. Now let's see content of that image. We can add that image from the evidence item in file menu, image file. Since we have provided AD1 encryption at the time of creation image, we are asked to provide password. The second entry in the evidence tree contains image added by recently. As we can see here, there are two entries we have added previously. We can verify image file using hash function. If we want to verify this test101 image, then we have to click on this image, and from file menu there is option called verify drive or image. So this is a show result of the hash function from previously computed value and now current hash value. So these are current hash value, computed hash value, and these are value from report file, which is also stored with test101 file. We can see here both hash function are matched, means this file is not modified. These two files are some another file which is shown as unallocated space, means this file are currently deleted and that part of storage is not overwritten by any another file. There are three options available. We add to custom content image we have click finished. Another is export file. If we want to select any particular file from image, then we can select that export file, and we can see destination for the file we want to save. Another option is for hash list. If we want to hash list for particular this file only, then we can capture that using this export file hash list. We have to provide a destination address for that. This file is a comma separated value. This is content of that file. We can see file name in both digest of SHA1 and MD5. In the aptk imager, we can mount any image file as a physical or as a logical drive. If we first see in physical drive, there is only one entry available, which is hard drive in this computer. Let us check after mounting an image. We select image mounting. We have to provide destination address of the image. This is DD image. These are options for mount type, physical, logical, or physical only and logical only. These are drive letter, which is all available letters of drive. These are available mount method, which is block device, read only. Another is a writable, and another is file system and read only. Let us take by default. If we click here mount image, then we can see all mapped image list which are currently mounted by FTK imager. We can see here first entry, which name is physical drive 1, method of the mounted image, which is block device read only, is by default. is partition and this is location of the image mounted. If you want to unmount any image, then we have to select that image and click on this unmount image. Now let's check the entry in physical drive. In physical drive, we can here see another entry which we have mounted right now. So we can see this mounted image in evidence tree. These are some unallocated space with that image mounted file. We can see all the files that have previously in that image. The root folder, this is unallocated file. And apart from this, there is also one another file.